Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is LCD, and today we're going to be having a little bit of a discussion video. It's not going to be too long, but this video is going to be pretty controversial. The topic's pretty controversial itself, so just to give you guys a fair warning, if you guys don't agree with me, you guys can, that's fine, but go ahead and respect my opinion. And if you don't agree with me, go ahead and leave your comments in the comment section below and let me know what you guys think about what we're getting ready to talk about in today's video. So, if you guys haven't heard already, there's a new game trailer out for a game called Hatred. It actually just came out this month, not too long ago, a few days ago, and it's been sparking up a lot of buzz across the world and, across various gaming news sites and non-news sites and various press and things like that. And not for a good reason. It's because of how interesting, I'll just use the word interesting, this trailer is. It's actually the first trailer that I've seen in my 23 years of living on this world, that has actually disgusted me. And it's not a game trailer that makes me want to play the game. It's a game trailer that wants me to, rethink my life or rethink, other people's lives. And, I'll put a link in the description so you guys can go ahead and check out this trailer for yourself. But fair warning, I would definitely watch the rest of this video before you even consider going to watch this trailer if you have not yet already. So the whole point of the Hatred game is to kill people. Now, this may sound just like any other, first-person shooter or any other game out there that exists today, but this is actually a lot different. So the reason why I say this is because, let's take a game like Call of Duty. Call of Duty is a war game. And not so much nowadays, but in the beginning, Call of Duty 2 and Modern Warfare, those were war games. Your sole purpose was to go through the campaign, kind of like role-playing, act out what you would have done in World War II and things like that. What would you have seen? And that's what kind of like shooters have been in the past, where, you don't just run around shooting people and killing people 24/7, every second of the day. There's actually some story there. You were learning what the Nazis were doing, World War II and things like that. But in this sense, in this Hatred game, your entire point is killing people. And it doesn't matter how you kill them. It doesn't matter why you kill them. You just want to kill them. And so this is really terrible, because there's actually been a lot of this going around in the world, in our real lives, every single day. You remember when The Dark Knight Rises came out and that guy shot up that movie theater? That was because he was influenced by the Bane or the Joker character. He's like, I'm going to go into this movie theater and shoot a bunch of innocent people for no reason. He wasn't right. He wasn't right in the mind. There was something wrong with him that influenced him to go kill people. There was no right or reason for it. He just wanted to do it because he thought it would have been fun. That was his whole purpose. And to this day, actually, he still hasn't told us why he did it. He said, I wanted to play the Joker and kill people. That's pretty much why he did it. But that's not a real reason now, is it? So let me go ahead and describe this trailer for you guys. So at the beginning of the trailer, I've actually watched it and I regret doing that. But at the beginning of the trailer, the main focus of this guy, he doesn't actually tell us his name. He's like covered in this really black and white, trailer. He's covered in all black. He's got this long hair, and he's basically telling us, I hate the world. I'm going to go out and commit genocide. I don't care what's wrong with me. I'm going to burn in hell anyways, right? So I'm just going to kill everybody that I can, because I hate everybody in the world and everything in it. So that was the entire beginning part of the trailer. And then after that, he goes outside of his house. He gets his shotgun ready and all of his weapons and things like that. He goes outside of his house and just starts killing people. He's killing cops. He's killing children. He's killing wives. And he's killing wives and fathers and dads and mothers and uncles. He's killing cats and dogs. He's shooting basically anything and everything, and it's really, really gory. He's taking shotguns to people's face and, blowing off their heads. He's shooting, little girls in the stomach and things like that. And there's no rhyme or reason for any of the killing. A main focus of a video game is usually a premise. And the premise of this video game is basically to kill people, because the main, I would say antagonist of the game, doesn't like the world, so he's going to go out and head and do all of these things that, everyone's been so against in the world lately. Not too long ago in my area, there was this guy who went into a local coffee shop and shot 6 cops. And that's pretty terrible. Like, he killed himself afterwards, actually. He just went inside, killed 6 cops in this coffee shop, and, killed himself afterwards. There was no rhyme or reason or why he did it, and they never found out why he did it. He just did it. And it's stuff like that that influences people, especially little kids. There was not too long ago, there was a story about two little girls who actually killed their friend. They were only like 12 or 13 years old, who actually killed their friend because they were playing this horror game. I forget what it's called, but the main character in the game told them to go out and kill your friends, you know, stuff like that. And they actually did it in real life. And, you know, it is up to parents to, you know, help their kids understand about this stuff. The game's rated M or rated A for a reason. But kids get a hold of stuff anyways. Kids get a hold of drugs? Kids get a hold of alcohol? So, you know, I don't think the argument of, you know, parents are supposed to be doing their job actually works most of the time, because most of the time it really doesn't. It's up to the kids to understand. It's up to the parents to teach their kids about this stuff. But at the same time, you know, the kids themselves are not going to listen all the time. Like, let's be honest here. Kids don't listen to their parents. And so when they go out and do this stuff or go out and play these violent video games, such as, you know, the Hatred that's coming out early next year, you know, they're going to be influenced by it. Okay, so this guy's entire purpose in life is to kill people and commit genocide. He actually says it in the trailer, I'm going to go out and commit genocide. There's no rhyme or reason for it. He's just going to go out and kill people. And it's a top-down third-person shooter, and then when he kills somebody, it goes into this kill animation and whatever. It's pretty gruesome. Like I said, I'll put a description in the video if you guys want to watch it, but it's not really worth it. It's pretty stupid. But it's just stuff like this. Like, when someone who's not right in the head gets a hold of a game like this and gets influenced by it, you know, cults exist all over the world. So when a video game is telling you to go out and commit genocide, people are going to do it. It's happened before. It's happened, like, it's been happening for the last 5 years or so. It's been really, really prevalent. Just people just going out and killing people. There was a guy, you know, about 6 months ago who actually went out and killed a bunch of girls in a sorority because he felt like, you know, he didn't have a reason for it. He just wanted to go do it. So it's people like that who aren't right in the head, or little kids who are influenced by this stuff, you know, I'm not going to say that this game is going to cause video games cause people to kill people, because it's not true. You know, I play Gears of War, I play all those games, and the reason why it's different from this is because Gears of War has a premise. You know, it's fake, it's not real, and stuff like that. The same thing with The Hatred. It's fake and it's not real. It's a video game. The things you're seeing in there aren't actually happening in the game, but outside the world, these things are actually happening. People are going out and committing genocide. People are going out and shooting at little kids and girls and, you know, animals and things like that. It's just, it's wrong. What about the shooting that just happened at that school earlier? I think this was a couple years ago, actually, now, where some guy just went into a school and started shooting up a bunch of kids and teachers and stuff like that. It's pretty awful, guys, and I don't really know. I don't really have too much to say about this, a lot more. Except for the fact that a game like this should not exist. The entire purpose of a game is not to should not be to commit genocide. And I don't know. You guys can go watch the trailer and judge for yourselves. But at the same time, you know, there are people out there who would enjoy something like this. You know, taking out a chainsaw and just going kill people for no reason. You know, it's sick. The world is sick. But I don't want that to deter me from thinking that there are still good people in the world. The world is still a really nice place. But it's just those people who aren't right in the head and other things like that that kind of just, you know, deter us from that. So that's going to wrap it up for my video today, guys. Let me know what you guys think about what I think about the trailer. Should the game exist? Should it be released? You know, should... Like I said, the whole purpose of the game should not be to commit genocide. There should be a rhyme or reason around it. It should tell a story. It should, you know, maybe it's based on a real life person who thought that. And at the end of the game, maybe, you know, he comes to terms with something and he understands something or whatever. You learn about a person, how he's sick. It doesn't make any sense no matter what. But I'm going to end the video, guys, here. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is LCD. Catch me on Twitter @GamerLCD. Check out my live streams at twitch.gamerLCD. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.